Hello, colleagues. Please, you're welcome to Kanga Academic Tutors. My name is Desmond Kanga, a student at the University of Mines and Technology, Takwa. And I would like to be your academic tutor for the coming days. So, if you like me to be your tutor, please subscribe, like, and comment. Comment on anything you see in this video. If you don't like it, or if there's some improvement you want me to add it, and just comment, and I'll see to it. So now, we're going to look at one of the topics in GMAT, that is in level 100, called magnetic declination. Magnetic declination. But before that, I would like to take you through some small advice. You have to be motivated before you go on to the studies. And what I'll say is that if you're having a goal you want to achieve, you have to be disciplined. You have to be disciplined to some level before you can do that. Because discipline is a bridge between goal and accomplishment. So if you are not disciplined, any target you set for yourself, there's no way you're going to achieve it. There's no way you're going to achieve it. Because there will be some hindrance. There will be some things on your way that will try to what, impede you or hinder you in doing the things you want to do. So before you can do it, you have to be what? Disciplined. And don't always try to compare yourself to your friends. Don't say that my friend is not doing this, so I'm also not going to do it. Don't say that my friend did this and it didn't work, so I can't also try. You are different from him, and he also different from you. So don't compare yourself. And also in your studies, just depend on God and depend on yourself and try to make it. Try to see that what you are doing is the right thing. If you get it wrong, that's not the end. You can just what? Do it. If it's true, that's not the end. You can say what? Watch it again and make it. Bill Gates once said, he said, if you compare yourself to people in this world, it means that you're insulting yourself. You don't have to compare yourself to your friends before you take a step. Take a step and do it. When they see you doing it, when they ask you, you tell them you did it and you have made it. And also, Proverbs chapter number 18 verse 10 says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and they are saved. So, do your studies, depend on God, and blame yourself and be disciplined. And I know you can make it because some people have tried it and they've made it. So you can also what, make it. Now, let me move on to today's topic, that is magnetic declination. Magnetic declination. Now, what is about magnetic what? Declination. What's about magnetic declination? Let's look at the definition. It says magnetic declination is the horizontal angle between the true meridian and the what? And the magnetic meridian. The angle or the horizontal angle between the true meridian and the magnetic meridian. Note that angle. It's not a vertical angle. It's what? A horizontal what? Angle. Because we have a vertical angle and we have what? Horizontal what? Angle. Okay, let's see the diagram. This is a diagram depicting declination. Now we're having TM starting for true meridian, you're having MM starting for magnetic what? Meridian. And they mix an angle of what? Theta. At their intersection what? Point. So that theta there is called what? The declination. The degrees of which the poles are being separated from each other is called what? The declination. Okay. Now you're having some types of what? Declination. You have first one, having the declination west. You can see the diagram. Declination what? West. And what is about declination west? It says if the magnetic meridian, that's the MM, is on the left side of the true meridian, the horizontal angle formed between the two meridian is called the declination what? West. That is theta W. If the magnetic meridian is on the left side of the true meridian, so you can see in the diagram that the MM is on the what? The left side. As you're watching the video, you can see that it's at the what? At the left side of the what? The TM. So that's what we call declination what? West. The MM is at the left side of the TM, and it makes an angle of what? Theta. Now, when you say horizontal angle, as I said earlier, we have vertical angle, we have horizontal angle. Now, let me do this practical way for you to understand it. Now, I know some of you have used the compass for surveying before. Now in the compass, when you're holding the compass in your hand, you see two poles, one depicting the magnetic meridian and one depicting the true what? Meridian. Another name for magnetic meridian is the same as magnetic north, and there another name for true meridian is the same as true what? North. So the poles, one depicting true north, one depicting magnetic what? North. Now, this post also help us to calculate the bearings, or to take the bearings from the what? From the compass. So, these two posts, their positions on the compass help us to differentiate whether they are in the declination west or in the declination what? East. Now, the horizontal angle, you can see that, let me take the room for example. You can see that in the room, you're having a floor, you're having a what? The wall. The floor is what you step on it, and the wall is what you can what lean on it. And now, when you take the floor for example, you can see that in the compass, you also have what? The floor. We have that two poles what? Lying on the what? On the floor. So that angle they make on the floor of the watch, the compass, it's called the horizontal angle, because the angle there is being formed on the horizontal plane on the compass. The angle is not formed on the wall. If it was formed on the wall, it would be accepted to be vertical angle, but now they are forming on the what? On the horizontal plane. So it's called the horizontal what? Angle. Okay, let me move to the next type. So the next type, you're having declination east. So you can see in the diagram, declination what east, and it says if the magnetic meridian is at the right side of the true what meridian, the horizontal angle formed between them is called declination what east. The horizontal angle formed between them is called the declination east. So that is when the MM is at the right side of the true what meridian. So now I've explained us about horizontal angle, so I hope now you know about that. So these are the two types of what declination. We're having declination east, declination west. So as I said earlier, I said that two poles, they help us to calculate two what, to calculate bearings on the what, on the compass. It says also, as you saw in the what succeeding what slides, you can see that we have two what lines, they each carrying what arrows, one indicating TM and the other MM. These are all bearing lines. They help us what calculate what bearings, meaning on a compass you can calculate two types of what bearings there. Calculate the magnetic bearing and then on the true what bearing. Keep it in your head, you can calculate magnetic bearing and what two bearing. You're having many types of what bearings when it comes to geomatics. You're having four bearing, you're having back bearing, you're having quadrantal bearing, but on this topic we're just looking at magnetic bearing and what true bearing. Now let's differentiate between magnetic bearing and what true what bearing. Magnetic bearing. The magnetic bearing of a line is the horizontal angle which a survey line makes with the magnetic what meridian or the magnetic what north. I hope we know the magnetic north. So the angle the survey line, it's not the true meridian, the survey line makes with the what magnetic what meridian. It's what you call magnetic what bearing. That's the what the angle, that angle there. Okay, so you can see the diagram, you're having MM, you're having what TM. So that angle between the MM and the survey line is what you call the what the magnetic what bearing. Now we move on to the true bearing. The true bearing of a line is the horizontal angle between the true meridian and the survey line. So that's the angle between the true meridian and the what? The survey line. Let's see the diagram. You're having TM and what? The survey line. That's what, so that angle there is called the what? The true what? Bearing. And it's being read from, for here it's being read from the what? The MM to the what? The survey line. And here it's from the what? The true bearing towards the survey line. Keep that one in your head. Let's look at some problems that help us to understand what you're talking about. Now it says find the true bearing if the magnetic bearing of a survey line is 128 degrees 30 minutes, and they give us declination about 5 degrees what west. The W there means west. Now in this problem, you have to know your parameters in the what the problem. You have to know what it's about true bearing, what it's about magnetic bearing, survey line, 128 degrees, and the declination was 5 degrees west. And you have to know the position in which the declination will be. So let's look at the problem. But note, if the declination is west, meaning the magnetic meridian will always be on the left side of the true what meridian. If it's being mentioned in the question that the declination is what west, the magnetic meridian will always be on the left side of the what the true what meridian. So keep that one in your head. So let's see the diagram. So you're having the magnetic what meridian is on the what the left side on the true what meridian. We're having the survey line here. So we need this angle, the angle here from the survey line to the MM dot the magnetic what bearing, and they give us the declination. The declination is to the what, to the west. So it's what, 5 degrees. So this is it. And you can see that the declination is a subset of the what, the whole what bearing of the what, the magnetic bearing. So we are told to find the what, the true what bearings. We are looking for this small angle here. The small angle here. That's what we are looking for. Okay. So the parameters they give us, the magnetic bearing to be what, 128 degrees, 30 minutes. Declination is 5 degrees west. So this is the formula we're going to use. So true bearing, that is what, from here to here, is equal to the total and the total bearing here, that's the magnetic bearing, minus the declination what west, this angle here, to get what, this what angle, that is the true what bearing. So this is the formula. Now note something, it only minus if it is declination what west. This sign here, it's only minus if it is what declination what west, or it is being mentioned in the question that it is what declination what west. Okay, continuation of the problem. So you're having 128 degrees minus 5, so 128 degrees, 30 minutes minus 5 degrees. So this one is in degrees, this one is 128 watt degrees. So just subtract the degrees from the water degrees and add the rest. So only subtract 5 from 128 to get 123 degrees 30 watt minutes. So this is the first what problem. So this is our what, the answer of our true what bearing. Answer of our what, true bearing. Now let's look at the next problem. Says find the true bearing if the magnetic bearing of a line is 85 degrees 30 minutes and declination is what, 6 degrees what east. 6 degrees what east. So let's look at the solution. Says if the declination is east, the magnetic meridian will be on the right side of the true what meridian. If the declination is what east, the magnetic meridian will be on the right side of what, the true what meridian. Oh, it was said in the first what slide that it is what in the what, in the west, to be at the what, at the left side, but this one is what east, to be at what, right side. So you're seeing the diagram, you're having the MM, so that what, that the right side of the what, the TM, and the declination is what east, that is the angle between the TM and the what, the MM, and the angle between the MM and the what, the survey line, that is the what, the magnetic what bearing was given to us to what, to be 85 degrees 30 watts minute. So keep that one in your what, in your head, how you can what, draw the diagram, because the diagram will help you to do the work very what easy. If you're able to represent it in a diagram form, you do the work what, very what easy. A continuation, so they give us the magnetic bearing to be 85 degrees 30 minutes, declination to be what, so 6 what degrees what east. Therefore, now just in the diagram, we are finding the true what bearing And the true bearing one will say that it was the angle between the TEM and the what, the survey line. So this angle here is the what, the true what bearing. So if you find this angle here, meaning you have to add this one plus this one to get the what, the total what bearing. So the formula will be true bearing equals to magnetic bearing plus declination what east. So now we are adding. So we are having true bearing equals to 85 degrees 30 minutes plus 6 degrees. You just add 6 to the 85 degrees and get 91 and add the rest. We have 91 degrees 30 watts minutes. So these are what our true what bearing. So thank you for watching this video. The name is Kanga Academic Tutors. If you want more videos, kindly subscribe, like and comment. This will promote me to do more for you. My next tutorial will be on local attraction when doing traversing, and also how to use rise and fall method and collimation method in leveling calculations. So if you want more videos, just subscribe to my channel, like and comment. Thank you very much. God bless you.